السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته my students. Now I'm speaking about product, service and brands building customer value. One of a marketing mix or the first element of a marketing mix is the product. It's a product. What's product? Anything we offer to the market that satisfying a customer need want. This is a chapter outline. And now, what's product? What's product? Product, it's anything that can be offered in a market for attention, acquisition, use, or consumption that might satisfy a need or want. But service, it's a product that consists of activities or benefits or satisfaction that essentially intangible and doesn't result in the ownership of anything. There are no pure product or a pure service. Actually, we are offering a market offering. It's a combination of a tangible and intangible objects. What is the leverage of a product or service? There are three levels. The first level is the core customer value of a core product. It's a core product, I mean a main function. The second level, it's actual product. Actual product, when we turn off a core product into actual. I mean product feature, brand name, quality level, design, backing, whatever. The third level of a product levels, it's augmented product. It's additional benefits we deliver to our customer. The core customer value, this is a first level or product level. Product planners need to think about products and the service on three level, each level adds more customer value. The most basic level in the core is the core customer value, which addresses the question, what's the buyer really buying? At the second level, product planners must turn the core benefits into an actual product. They need to develop a product and the service feature, the design, quality level, a brand name, and packing. A third or finally, product planners must be an augmented products around the core benefits and the actual by offering additional consumers, services, and benefits. What about product classification? We are focusing here on consumer products. We classify our products and services into four types. The first type, it's convenience product. Second type, it's shopping product. The third type, it's a specialty product. Now we will focus on just three types of a products. As I said, convenience, shopping, and specialty. Convenience product, it's consumer products and services that the customer or consumer usually buys frequently, immediately, and with the minimum comparison and the buying effort. Like magazines, newspapers, candy, fast food. A second type of a product, it's shopping products, consumer product and services that the customer converts carefully on suitability, quality, and the price and the style, like furniture, cars. Specialty products, especially or specialty products, it's a consumer products and service with a unique characteristics or brand identification for which a significant group of buyers is willing to make a special purchase effort, like medical services, designer clothes, high-end electronics, whatever. The last type, it's unsold products, it's consumer products that the consumer doesn't know about, or know about, or knows about, but doesn't normally think of buying, like life insurance or blood donation. And now we compare, between product types. If we are speaking about consumer buying behavior, a convenience product, we are purchase it frequently with the minimum little planning and the minimum effort. A second, less frequent, much planning and shopping effort. Specialty, strong brand preferences and loyalty. And we will not speak about unsold product because it's out of our scope in our project. Price, convenience, it's a low price. Shopping, higher price. Specialty, it's a high price. We cannot compare it with another type of product because it is a product with the unique characteristics. Distribution, in convenience, intensive distribution. Shopping, selective distribution, and specialty, it's exclusive distribution. What about promotion? We should use a mass promotion with the convenience. All type or all tools, promotion tools, we can use it with shopping products, but specialty products, we use a more carefully targeted promotion by both the producer and resellers. Okay. Product and the service decision. Product and the service decision. We should decide, or we should take a decision related to a product type at three levels. Individual, product line, product mix. Individual product, where we speak about product attribute, branding, packing, and labeling. When we are speaking about a product or a service attribute, we are speaking about quality, features, style, and the design. Quality means freedom from the facts. Freedom from the facts. Feature, it's a competitive tool for differentiating a product from a competitor's products. Style and design. Design is more than skin deep. It goes to the very heart of a product. A good design contributes to a product's usefulness as well as its look. Style describes the appearance of the product. It can be eye-catching, but design contributes to a product's usefulness as well as its looks. It means that design is a larger concept than style, or let's say that style is a part of design. Brand. What's brand? Brand, it's a name, term, sign, or design, or a combination of these that identify the maker or a seller of a product or a service. When we speak about Nestle, it's a name. Pure Life, it's term. And when we are speaking about the logo or the design, it's a sign or design. And all of it's a combination of these elements. Brand name becomes the base on which a whole marketing story can be built about the product. 3. Packing or packaging involves designing and producing the container or wallpaper for a product. The primary function of the package or packing was to hold and protect the product. We should know that there are many functions of packaging, but we should know that that the main function of our packing is to carry and protect our customer right. Labels identify the product or brand, describe attributes, and provide promotion. There are three functions of label. The label identifies the product or brand. The label describes several things about the product, and finally, the label promotes the brand. Second type of decision we should take is product design decision. Product design, it's a group of products that are closely related because they function in a similar manner or sold to the same customer groups are marketed through the same type of outlets or fell within a given price range. Product line length. Product line length is the number of items in the product line. And we take two types of decision in a product line decisions. Product line filling or product line stretching. But first, let's say that product line length is the number of items in the product line. Manager need to analyze the product line. Product line filling involves adding more items within the present range of the line. I mean within the same segment we target. There are several reasons for product line filling. Extra profits, satisfying dealers, using excess capacity, or plugging the holes to keep out competitors. Product line stretching occurs when a company lengths its product line beyond its current range. Companies located at the upper end of the market can stretch their lines downward. Companies located at the lower end of the market can stretch their product line upward by adding prestige product to their current products. And finally, companies located in the middle range of the market can stretch the line in both directions. Product line mix. A product mix or product portfolio consists of all the product lines and its items that a particular seller offers for sale. Product mix consists of all products and items that particular seller offers for sale. Product mix weights refer to the number of different products the company carries. Product mix lengths refer to the total number of items the company carries within its product line. Product mix depth refers to the number of various offered over each product in the line. And finally, product mix consistency refers how closely related the various product lines are in end use production requirements, distribution channels, or some other way. When we speak about service marketing, we should consider that service, it's a product. It's a product, yes, with the unique characteristics. A nature or and the characteristics of a product is or are intangibility. One, intangibility. It means that services cannot be seen, tasted, felt, heard, or smelled before purchase. Inseparability. It means that service cannot be separated from their providers. Three, perishability. Service cannot be stored for the later sale or use. And variability. Quality of service depends on who provides them, and when, and where, and how. Service intangibility means that service cannot be seen, tasted, felt, heard, or smelled before they are bought. Service inseparability means that service cannot be separated from their providers. Whether or whatever the provider are people or machine. Service variability means that the quality of service depends on who provides them, as well as when, where, and how they are provided. And finally, service perishability means that service cannot be stored for a later sale or use. New subject, branding. Branding strategy, building strong brands. Brand equity means that differentiation effect that know the brand name has on customer response to product or its marketing. Brand or brands represent a consumer perception and feeling about the product and its performance. Everything that the product or the service means to the customer. Building strong brands. We will speak about brand positioning, brand name selection, brand sponsorship, and finally, brand development. Brand positioning means that marketeers need to position their brands carefully in target customer minds. And they can position their brands at any of three levels. Product attributes, product benefits, and the product beliefs and values. And we position our product brand or our brand like we position our market offering in chapter 7. We position our brand based on product attributes, product benefits, products, behave, and values. Brand name selection. A good brand can add greatly to a product's success. To select a good brand, you should consider some of condition, let's say condition, for a good brand. One, suggest benefits and the quality. A brand should just suggest benefits and the qualities. It should be easy to pronounce, easy to recognize, and remember, our brand should be distinctive, different from other brands, extendable when we are going to extend our business scope, translatable for the global economy, and the capable for registration and legal protection. Brand sponsorship. A manufacturer has four sponsorship options. A manufacturer brand, It means that the brand is manufactured, owned by manufacturer. Private brand, it means that I can't say my brand without saying our company. Licensed brand, it's a permission from a brand, from a company to another to use its brand. Co-brand, it means that two companies can put their names on the same brand. Maybe one more stronger than the other. Brand development strategy. There are four strategies. There are four strategies to develop your brand, considering two dimensions, brand name and product A category. Brand name, maybe it's existing or new, and product maybe existing or a new product. When we use existing brand with existing product, it's a line extension like Maggie. It offers us a chicken soup. If they are introducing a meat soup, they will introduce using the same brand with the same name. But when Mitsubishi, it's a Mitsubishi company, when they introduced a new products, they using existing brand with a new product. And also when a company introducing existing brand with a new product, it's mighty brands, like Procter & Gamble when they introduce Tide besides their main products area. And finally, if we are going to introduce a new product with a new brand, it means that new brands. To offer new product with a new brand. It's a new brand. Line extension occurs when company extends existing brand names to a new form, its color, size, whatever, or further. Brand extension extend a current brand name to a new or modified products in a new category. Mighty brands, companies often market many different brands in a given product category, like P&G introduces additional brands in the same category. And finally, new brands means that a company might believe that the power of its existing brand name is winning, and a new brand name is needed, or when it's enter new product category for none of the product's current brand's name are appropriate. New product development process. The first step, idea generation. Second, idea screening. Third, concept development. Four, marketing strategy. Five, business analysis. Six, product development. Seven, taste marketing. And finally, commercialization. And this is the product life cycle strategies. Starting with the product development introduction stage, when a product enters the market, growth stage, maturity stage, and the decline. Let's speak about the different stages in a PLC. Product development. introduction, growth, maturity, and decline. And this is a product, it's a type of a product-derived strategies. When we are speaking about introduction stage, we are speaking about through sales growth, little or no profit, maybe no profit, high distribution and the promotion expenses. Second step or second stage, it's a growth stage. Sales increase, new competitors in the market, price stability or decline in to increase volume, consumer education and the profit increase, promotion and the manufacturer cost gain economics for skill. Maturity, slow down in everything, slow down in sales. Many suppliers substitute product and increase promotion, and need to support sales and profit. The company can try to modify the marketing mix, improving sales by changing one or more marketing mix elements. And finally, decline stage. Maintain the product, harvest the product, drop the product. So the decline may be slow or declining in sales volume and profit, maybe losses. So the company should decide to maintain the product or to harvest the product or to drop the product. This is our product life cycle, and this is the end of chapter 8. Thank you, my student, and wish you all the best.